we gather, may your spirit work within us. As we gather, may we glorify your name, knowing well that as our hearts begin to worship, we'll be blessed because we came.
Aside so we can listen for your presence. so we can sense your presence. It is in Christ that we pray. Amen. Amen. Join in singing "Oh for a Thousand." How many verses of this "Oh for a Thousand" times are we going to sing?
I can't remember. I think maybe, I don't remember.
We'll sing them until we get tired of singing?
Yeah.
And when I hear them not singing too much, we'll cut it off. Some scripture about how Jesus was in, well, it wasn't a church, it was a synagogue. And it was a person there that had a demon inside of him. And the person in the midst of Jesus' teaching, the person stood up, actually, I think they were all standing, but he cried out. Right in the middle of the teaching, he cried out. Have you ever had anything like that happen when the pastor was preaching? Did anybody stand up and say, "What's going on?" or something like that? That would be really something if somebody did that, right? Mm-hmm. I think you may be not anything bothering you, but I bet there are people here today that got some things that are really, they're really upset about. They don't feel good about. Sometimes I get that way. You know, I woke up one day this last week. I got up and went out in the kitchen and I sat down at the kitchen table and I said to myself, I don't want to do anything today. I just want to stay home. I don't want to go out. This is one of the days that I do go out. But I did not feel like going out. It was almost like I had a demon inside of me saying, what's the worth of it? What's the sense in going out? Is it going to make any difference? I really had to talk to myself to get beyond my thinking of that. That was like a demon inside of my thinking that what I'm doing really isn't that important. And I think what every one of us doing, you too, all of us, what we're doing is very important, and we need to keep doing that, particularly when we're doing what God wants us to do. And I hope that we can, every one of us, can somehow connect with God in prayer or some way so that we can, you know what God wants us to do. Sometimes I lose that connection, but thankfully God is very forgiving and he just says, come on back to me. Let's pray. Almighty God, Thank you for being so forgiving and so giving. Forgiving is a giving. And thank you for healing us, every one of us. Whenever we come to you, you touch us and you heal us. We thank you, Lord, for your great love for us that is far beyond what we understand. It is in Christ that we pray. Amen. Okay, people, what's a good thing? I know I'm not supposed to do that.
Oh, that's fine.
Would you pray with me? Almighty God, as we come, Lord, as we come to reading your word is sacred. This particular reading from Scripture has to do with Jesus. It is special. You know us, Lord. You know every single one of us. Every single one of us. And you know what we need. Every one. So help us to hear what you want us to hear. Help me to get out of the way. But help us, Lord, to hear what you want us to hear. It is in Christ that we pray. Amen. We're going to read a little 2 points before we read the scripture. Mark, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, especially, wrote their what we call gospel. They wrote their writings. Number one, for the purpose of convincing people that Jesus is the promised Messiah. Sometimes I forget that. I put that aside and I don't think about that. But that's really, I think, one of the primary reasons they wrote was to convince non-Christians that Jesus certainly is the Messiah. We look at the Gospels differently than what those people would. And there are people, maybe some of our friends and neighbors, that would look at the scriptures altogether differently than what we would, because they don't have that basic belief that Jesus is the Messiah, that we have that basic belief that Jesus is the promised Messiah. So we need to keep that in mind, that there are those people out there, and there were in Jesus' time as well, that that didn't know that he was the Messiah. This is the today's reading is from the first chapter of Mark. Mark is a very compacted gospel compared to Matthew and Luke, particularly compared to them. Mark, if we read earlier in that same chapter, we would read about John the Baptizer. You remember John the Baptizer. We would read about Jesus being baptized and how he was confirmed by God the Father there at the river. We would read about how Jesus wrestled with Satan in the wilderness. We would read about how Jesus called the first disciples. We read all those things before we get to today's reading. And the first 20 verses, we read about all those things. And then we get to today's reading. They went to Capernaum. That would be Jesus and his disciples went to Capernaum. And when the Sabbath came, Jesus went into the synagogue and began to teach. The people were amazed at his teaching because he taught them as one who had authority, not as the teachers of the law. Just then, a man in their synagogue who was possessed by an impure spirit cried out, "What do you want with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." "Be quiet," Jesus said sternly. "Come out of him." And the impure spirit shook the man violently and came out of him with a shriek. The people were all so amazed that they asked each other, "What is this? A new teaching and with authority. He even gives orders to impure spirits and they obey him." And of course, news about him spread quickly over the whole region of Galilee. Lord. What's next? Closing hymn. Savior, again, tonight, dear name we raise. I don't know that hymn. You're going to teach me. We yearn for that peace, Lord. We yearn for that peace. Help us to stay so connected with you this week that we grasp at least a little of that peace. Be with us in such a way that we know that you walk with us. It is in Christ that we pray. Amen.
God be with you till we meet again. Bye.